Hi, this time I will make rain ripple that occurs in the puddle. First, import the texture uploaded in the video and double-click it. You can see 16 textures are connected in order in a 4x4 format. Then, double-click on the rain puddle material you created earlier to open the window. After creating the flipbook node, click while holding down the keyboard T to create a texture sample. Set the uploaded ripple flip texture and connect it to the flipbook node. Then, if you preview the texture, you can see the flipbook animation is moving in a certain frame unit. Next, press 1 on the keyboard and click to create a constant node and set the value as 4. If you set it to rows and columns, images are divided into a 4x4 format, and you can see that 16 images appear in order. Next, after creating a time node, click it while holding down the M on the keyboard to create a multiply and connect it. After that, hold down the keyboard S and click to create a parameter and connect it to the multiply node in order to adjust the time value with an instance. Now, connecting the multiply node to flipbook, you are allowed to adjust the speed of the flipbook animation. Next, after creating the text coordinate node, create a multiply and parameter node as before, and connect them so that the number of UVs can be adjusted to instance. Next, create a pattern node to express the notion of ripple and connect it like the video. Next, after creating an append node, make 2 parameters and connect them to create X and Y coordinates. After that, connect it to the panner, allowing you to set the direction of ripple's movement. Next, create a frac node, connect it to the panner, and connect it to flipbook's UV. If you preview the frac node and increase the value of ripple UV, you can see that the area is divided by the number of UVs. Because the frac node outputs only the decimal point of the received value, only the decimal point of the UV coordinates was outputted. Now, if you preview the texture sample, you can see the flipbook works with the increased number of UVs. Next, create a component mask node and connect it with the texture sample to extract red and green and use only the ripple part, excluding the background. Next, create a multiply node and a parameter node. And if you connect the nodes shown in the video, you can adjust the intensity of ripple's normal. Next, after creating the append node, connect the multiply node and the blue node of the texture sample to make it in float 3 format so that it can be connected to the normal lerp. Now, after copying the nodes created so far, change the parameter names of the copied nodes little by little so that the parameter values do not overlap with each other. When you're done, hold down the keyboard A and click to create an add node, and then connect the two ripple nodes to make the ripple appear more irregular. And once again, create an add node and connect it with the add node of the previous rain puddle normal to merge with each other. Finally, if you connect the add node to the lerp node as shown in the video, you can see the ripple appear in the puddle. When you're done, save it and exit to the content browser. Now, click on the rain puddle instance you have created to open the window. After checking all of the new parameter groups, adjust the parameters to create the desired rain ripple. You can adjust the desired value by placing the cursor on the scroll box of the parameter and dragging it. Once you have adjusted the value as you want, save it and look at the world. You can see that the ripple of the puddle appears as the set value of instance.